Doug's Organic Wood Carving. It was kind of funny. I was driving through Leadville, Colorado, a couple summers ago, and going down Main Street, we were going to go camping out by Turquoise Lake, and there on Main Street was this pile of wood, and it said...
Is that too dark for you?
No, I'm used to this. I carve in the dark. But the sign said organic firewood. I thought, wow, that's cool. So having taught science for as long as I did, okay, so in science, organic means something that is alive or was alive. Okay, agriculture has a different connotation. But anyway, so something that is alive or was alive. So all the wood carving that I do is organic. Okay, so what happens is if I decide to do a golf ball, then I just turn the hat around, seeing as how it was never alive. But anyway, all right. So we get that out of the way. This is dedicated to the preservation of fingers. So you're going to hear this, hopefully, from all the instructors or the people that are doing these instructional hours. Have a glove, okay? And I got my kids' tools and gloves, and then my one son put it on the right hand rather than the left hand, okay? So he had the glove on the hand that isn't going to get cut. But anyway, we had to explain to him that, okay, it goes on the hand that holds the wood. All right, you want to have sharp tools, and there's the guy out there sitting next to me. He's got a grinder and stuff. But anyway, if you come down to the north end and want to learn how to carve, okay, there's tools there that either you, if you get approved, or someone will help you, okay, get your tools sharpened up. So, and obviously, if you buy better tools, they're going to hold the edge better than cheap ones. All right. Today, what I want to do is, this little guy, okay, it's out of a 1x1 piece of wood. And basically, if you get, it's 4 inches. So you can get an 8-inch, and you can do them butted up, and you can do 2. So basically, I don't know how many relatives you have, but for me, okay, in a weekend, I can get all my relatives something for Christmas. And that's with even an extended family. But, all right. So, a couple things about cutting. Okay, there's basically a few different cuts that you're going to have to make. And I'll go through them. We'll do it on this piece of wood here. Okay, so first of all, you're going to cut away from yourself. Okay, and when you do that, your hand is going to be below the blade. Okay, and then you're going to use your thumb on the back to just carve that off. Okay, and the thinnest part of the blade is up here at the top. So basically, if you want to take off, you know, a good chunk, then you want to use that out towards the tip rather than back here towards the handle. All right, that's one cut. So away from you, the hand is below, and then you are just popping it off. The sharper it is, the better you're going to be. Okay, then we're going to go towards you. Okay, now when I do this, I want to get my thumb out of the way. Now, you may see carvers that actually have a thumb guard for their right hand, the hand that holds the knife. Okay, but you can do this by putting your thumb below the edge of the wood. Okay, and now I'm carving here. So, okay, and so I'm with the wrist, but my thumb is out of the way. So I can push against the wood, but I don't want to do it where it's the thumb is exposed to the end of the blade. Okay? So again, I'm cutting towards myself. Okay? And then you may have to make several more cuts. Okay? But you can get down to what you need. Okay. Another cut is a stop cut. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drive in there and then come back up to that cut and make it a clean chip. So again, I'm going to cut down and then cut back up and clean that out. So stop cut, what you're doing is cutting and then cutting back up to that cut. And then I'll get into a chip cut once I start on my Santa Claus. So what I've done, basically, with these, first of all, these two here are done with the flat side. And this one here is done in the corner. So we'll show you both, and so what we want to do here is, with this, we're going to make the top of his hood, so we have to trim this back, okay? So we take off all the corners. Hopefully, I stay in the frame here. I know last year I'd move around and nobody could see anything. All right, so I've got a pencil, I've got a Sharpie, whatever, and what I'll do up here is decide, okay, I want to cut so this top folds over. So again, I can make my stop cut and cut back up to it. Stop cut, cut back up to it. Now, I've put these lines on here to give me some idea. So the bottom is here, okay, and then I'm going to take a bandsaw or whatever and cut it, and then I'll have one on each end. But I put the lines here just for reference. And once I start carving, the lines are going to be gone, so I'm going to have to redraw them. And the more of these that you do, then, you know, you'll figure it out where to put them, or you may not need the lines. Okay. So, on the top here, we'll carve that off. And you see on the top, we've got the cut lines. It's kind of rough. And we want to get rid of that. And again, my thumb is below where the knife ends up. And then we can just keep trimming around. So I can put some contours on there. All right. So now you've got arms that you need to put on there. You've got the around the hood. You've got, you know, the fleece or whatever. So what I want to do, rather than using the knife to make these cuts, I'm going to use a V-tool. And the reason I use the V-tool is I'm not going to go as deep. And without going as deep, if I use the knife, then I'm going to tear the wood. And if I don't like where the line is, then in order to fix it, I'm going to have to go a lot deeper to get that cut line out of there. So I'll prep it with a V-tool. Okay, and a V-tool, if you can see the end of that, where are we? Okay, so it's just a V. You could do it with a knife and cut it at, you know, that angle with a stop cut and another cut. But anyway, you've got a tool for this. So we go across, and when you're carving, to make it easier, okay, you want to have the carving up against your chest, okay? You have much more control, and when you're out here, and I realize that because we're on television, okay, I get away. And I don't have the control if I'm here tucked it against my chest. So we make these cut lines here, and then we can go back with the knife. And start to cut that away. So we don't have to go very deep, but again, that first cut, you want to do it with the V-tool, and then you can fix it a lot more easily, Anyway, it's easier to fix, okay, if you don't do it with a knife. All right, so now we pretty much taken that trim from the front. Okay, now the front of this, we've got to flatten out. So we're going to take off, and we can actually take this off too, and we'll cut it later. Are there any questions? What's that?
In your hand where you put the toothpick, how do you drill that hole?
I'm trying to think. It's a, is it a 3/16? Whatever.
Is it bit?
Yeah. Yeah. So once I, with this, okay, you got to figure out what's the thickness of that. So just match up the bit. And then you got to kind of trim this back so that the, you know, after you're going to drill the hole in the mitt, okay, at an angle. So you got to kind of cut that out. But at the same time, you got to have room down here. So you have to keep feathering that away, and so that the toothpick will go all the way down. All right, so now we'll put a little nose on there to start with. So again, you draw these reference lines, but I don't know that I've ever made two the same. But you just start cutting and that looks okay. So keep going. All right. So how many Canadians we got in here? Are the rest Americans? Anybody from Wisconsin? All right. Where in Wisconsin? That's way down south. Up by Minneapolis. About an hour northeast. Yeah, my brother lives there. All right, so now let's take and get these arms out. So again, we're going to take the V tool. So are you nervous about the Packers yet?
We'll see.
All right, so we've got the arms, and then we'll take and put, I'll use a smaller V for the gloves.
You can do it on a flat side, you can do it on a flat side.
No. No, the only, okay, so obviously the face is a triangle. But with something this size, you know, it's once you get, you do a couple of them, you know, it's no big deal. No. But, you know, if you did some, maybe you'd figure out that one was easier for you than another. But I was doing the flat ones first. So, I think the one by one, this wood, it's you can get it from Heineke, which, you know, they're from Cumberland, Wisconsin, about, I don't know, 45 miles from where I grew up. So I probably, with this stick, probably came from a tree that I climbed when I was a kid. But anyway, I think it's probably $1.25 for a 12-inch piece. So you could actually get three of these out of there for, and then you'd have to paint them with, you know, the acrylic paints. And because these are old world Santas, you know, you can make them any color. And so the paints are, you know, $1.50 a bottle. And so, you know, you're looking at less than probably $10 total. You'd have to buy a toothpick. Well, I guess you could go to the restaurant, get a bunch of them. All right, so you start to round off the edges. And you don't need a one by one. You could, if you had a 1.5 by 1.5 or a 2 by 2, then you just change the height to keep it, you know, to scale. So it's not like this is. Set in stone, set in wood. Anyway, so down here I would cut this with the bandsaw, coping saw, or whatever saw you got. Okay, I really can't until I cut. And okay, so. Let's just show you. Okay, so when I cut this way, it doesn't want to just flake off. So I'm going against the grain. So I go the other way and it flies right off. But you won't know that until you start cutting. And once you, and I guarantee you, You're not going to be carving very long before you figure out that, okay, this is going against the grain, so I need to turn around and go the other way. But it's not something that you could look at here and find. But so as you're on one side, it's going one way, and as you go on the other side, it's going the other way, but it could change up here in the middle. But with this, you know, it's probably not that big a deal. But again, if it flips off like that, then you're with the grain. But if you're trying to go against it, you'll know. So then you just turn around and go the other way. So we'll get rid of all right, so we've got the face. Okay, then we gotta bring that down. And again, to do the shaving and stuff, I'm up here at the tip. I'm probably using the last half inch of the tip. So my knives are Helvey knives. You can get them online. They're high carbon. They hold an edge and Helvey, H-E-L-V-I-E. Okay, so now these hands for this, because they're in the middle like this, we just make them so that they're clenched or, okay, rather than being separated like that. So this one's not going to have a toothpick. Okay, so we'll join this club. Okay, so now, anytime you have three planes coming together, so I have the beard. So I have this plane, I have the glove, and I have the forearm. Okay, then I want to take out a chip. Okay, and what that does, it's going to give me a shadow, and then I will see the difference when it's sitting over there, okay, and with that shadow, then, you know, it'll make it more appealing to your relative when you give it to them. So, we're going to take a cut. So we're going to use the tip of the blade, go down, okay? And then we'll do the same thing where the glove meets the forearm. So we're going to go the top of the glove and also to the forearm. So we're separating that from the beard. And then we're going to separate the glove and the forearm. And now we just take out a chip. Okay, and then we'll do the same thing on the glove. Just take out a chip. And now you see that shadow. Now on something this small, okay, that's, well and good, but if you're going to do a caricature, you're going to want to do that on all those where there's three planes. You know, something that's bigger. And that will give you, before you paint it and everything else, you know, some texture. So we'll do the same thing down below. So, just clean that out. So now, you can see that there's a gap. Okay, we'll do the same thing up here with the nose. So we go down, and then down the nostril and go right back up in there, and now our nose popped out. So let me get rid of these marks. All right, so again, so now that nose is away from So then we do the same thing back here, go down, and just chip that out. So we have, all right, so our arm goes up there. planes. So if you have spare time, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, not this Monday because it's a holiday, but come on down to the North End and join us. Yeah, okay. Good idea. See, she agrees. Anyway, there's coffee and, well, a little bit of coffee, but a whole lot of BS. So if you're into that, you just make sure you come to listen for the first time. And then after that, okay, it's carte blanche. You can tell everybody your story too. But you have to go around and listen to everybody else's first. And then if you're really, really, really brave like I am, live here all summer, you know, live here all year, and then you get to go with five guys all summer. And you know what month it is because, okay, that second, okay, so June, you got that line of stories. And then the first part of July, they start over again. Now, this is honest to God. I'm the youngest out of all these people. So they say, well. All right, so now we'll proceed. So we want to put some on the beard. Okay, we'll put some lines. So, you know, you start out there, run some. And again, the more you do this, the more wild you can get, and you can change it up. But just use a V tool. So I put some pencil lines on there. But again, you don't need to do that. You can eyeball it. If you wanted to put a mustache on there, and then just, you know, you could just draw another line here. In fact, we can do that right now. So we can just mustache. So when are you going to start coming?
I've been trying for like 4 years.
I know. Last year you were right there and you said, you know, I'm going to try and get down there. So you need a ride or what?
I need to be a little bit older.
Okay. Well, you know, we do a couple weeks in the summer for kids. Are you here in the summer? Oh, well, come on down. We'll give you a chunk of soap. So I started out. In the 80s, I met this guy that's one of the caricature carvers of America. He lives in Colorado Springs, and he would come up to Leadville to this craft fair and carve. So he gave me a knife and a V-tool. His dad was a carver. And anyway, I would go and get pine knots and make wood spirits out of the pine knots. And but I was doing stained glass, and I was doing all sorts of stuff, so teaching. And so I didn't have a lot of, you know, time. I could do one, but I couldn't do them all. So I didn't do a whole lot of carving except for those pine knot wood spirits. And anyway, I retired from teaching, I guess, 3.5 years ago. So since then, I've taken this up. I've quit doing stained glass. And doing caricatures. So I went to, because he was one of the instructors in Tennessee, so I've gone the last 2 years just east of Nashville for a week. There are 5 instructors. Every day you get a new instructor, and you buy one of their rough outs. So when you go through the door out into the main hall here, on the table just to the right are these rough outs. So what it is the carver has already carved something, and they send it to Heineke or whoever, and they've got these 3D routers. So they'll take a chunk of wood that's the same size, and then there's like a stylus that goes on the original. And then the routers, so there may be 12 or 20 of these chunks of wood, it'll carve out most of the waste. And then all you have to do is detail. So these rough outs, though, well, they're like $25. But rather than starting with a block of wood, okay, you're starting with the shape, and all you have to do is refine it. That's easy. Anyway, no problem. All right, so let me get started on a flat one just to show you the difference. But okay, so you know, we got some work to do on this one. So my Wisconsin partner here, do you have a knife? You do? All right. Well, because, you know, you're the winner. The distance game, you. So I'm going to give you one of these to finish. Oh, yeah. And then, okay, if you cut yourself. Okay. I'm not going to be to blame. All right. So here's one that I started. Okay, so we're going to take that nose out of there. Okay, we've got. So now we have to round. So we got to go back to, you know, it's going to have to be like a triangle. Okay, so I may have to put these lines back in. But So the difference in these V tools, this one's a quarter inch, and these two are an eighth. So the thing is, you can get more depth. Obviously, if you don't go as deep, it's not going to get as much depth, but so, what's that? No, this is Kevlar with tree line and Provo. You can get them for like, I think these are about $15, but you can get them for 25, you know, in some places. But anyway, they've got cheaper ones, and they've got like the little dots on them. I don't know. Yeah, and what they do is they deflect the blade. I mean, that ain't gonna. That it's going straight through. Okay. But you can see that where I run the blade, okay, so it wears out. I've had this for probably a year. Actually, I had a new one. I should have brought it out today to show you. You know, I could have dressed up. But anyway. All right, where was it? But anyway, the Kevlar is it's going to protect you from the glancing blows. But again, if you drop a tool, let it go. Okay, rather than putting your foot out to try and stop it, because, you know, it's sharp and it could just go in your foot. Okay, the same thing trying to grab it. So if I drop the knife, just let it fall. And if you have to, you have to go get it resharpened. All right, so we'll get these arms. Ouch. Okay, up above. So we made that stop cut. We made a deep stop cut, and then we can carve down to it. Several strokes, and you can just keep going. And again, with this hand, you've got to get the top of it exposed so you can run your drill down to hold the toothpick. And the same thing at the bottom. So you can start carving this off and expose that. All right, so then this elbow, again, we need a stop cut. And we carve up to that cut. Stop cut. There. Put a stop cut on that shoulder. So we expose the shoulder, and then, you know, the hood kind of that nose out of there. So a year ago, I went over to Phoenix to Dave Stetson's to do a Santa Claus. And it's out there on my table. It's, I don't know, 13, 14 inches tall. Anyway, he's one of the guys that started the Caricature Carvers of America. So I went over to one of his classes. But the thing that I learned, it was phenomenal. We went to In-N-Out Burger for lunch. And you know those little things that they give you for ketchup? Those little dinky things? Yeah. So, you know, I'm from Wisconsin. That's what we eat, right? Prairie Home Companion, ketchup. Yeah. So I'd have to make 16 trips to get me enough of those damn things. He goes and he just opens that thing up. It's about that big. It's like a pie tin. He filled that thing up. He made one trip. Most amazing thing I learned out of the whole carving 3 days. Anyway. All right. Okay, so we got a couple arms back here. And we can actually put in a little belt. Get that elbow out of there. So, what's the temperature in Canada today? Well,
cold.
Just cold? Colder than hell? I thought it was all the same. When I was teaching at Yuma High, and I had to go back to Wisconsin in the first part of February for my mother was having something done. I don't know what it was. Anyway, I went to the lake in my hometown, and there were trucks out there and ice shacks, and a guy on a quad pulling his little kid behind on a inner tube. I got back to Yuma High and I said, "Well, kids, what is that?" I said, "That's a parking lot." Okay. So then I had to go back in May because then my dad was having something done. Well, I went to the same spot, so all the same houses were over there, but there was water. They've never seen snow, so anyway. Anyway. All right, so we're getting to the end of the road here. But as speaking of my Yuma High experience, Mark over there was right across the hall. Yeah, now, you know, since I don't know how many millions of kids I had over the years, but, you know, I've been out of Yuma High for over 10 years. So some of them I had 20-some years ago. They'll come up to me. I don't recognize them. Hey, Mr. Thompson, you remember me? Of course I say, yeah, sure. Did I flunk you? Anyway. All right, so you kind of get the drift here. So this one would have, actually, going up, so we would put the beard across from his gloves. And then this could be, you don't need to do that, you can cut that out. But anyway, you know, you've got a different fringe in the opening of the front, and that goes down. Let's get rid of that. And then, and the way that I would do that is, and again, there's, you got license because it's a old world Santa Claus, so you can make them any colors, and but to make more ornaments on there, and I think I've done this with this toothpick because it's painted on both ends, but okay, so you know, you'd paint that right there, and then let it dry, and then get a color that contrasts, and then you can put a dot on there with the toothpick rather than a brush. Okay, so then you can make kind of a bigger dot, then let it dry, use a different color, and put a second dot on there, and then if you really have a spare time problem, get a third dot and, you know, just use the tip. And then you'll have three concentric rings and you've got, you know, more ornament. So, so what I do, okay, I would bathe this in boiled linseed oil first, okay, and wipe it off. And then I can start painting. And what you have to do is paint it, you know, you do a bunch of them, and then, so you do all the white first or whatever, do the purple, whatever colors first, set them aside, let them dry for, you know, 15, 20 minutes, maybe half an hour. And then come back and do the next. And I use very thin, so, you can use a plastic plate for your palette and just put a drop of the acrylic paint and then get a drop of water, and then you're just going to do a bath. So it's going to be really thin paint, and the reason that you want to do that is, okay, you want this to look ceramic, so you just paint the hell out of it. Okay, or do you want it to see that, you want to see the grain so that people know that you carved it? All right, so when it's thin like this, you'll be able to see the grain.
Why do you boil it in oil?
Okay, it's boiled linseed oil. It's a yeah, it's Why do I put it in there? That seals it. That'll seal it. Okay. And then if you want to at the end, then you can spray it with a matte finish. Okay. And then... okay, they have antiquing, you know, in the, yeah, in the acrylics.
Yeah.
And yes, you could do that if you wanted to. So, you know, so you'd put that on and then you wipe it off, and then it makes it look like you dragged it in the dirt or something. Yeah. I just got yelled at by my buddy in Colorado Springs because I hadn't done that. And big deal. I can't even find it down here. So he sent me a picture of what the bottle looked like. So I went to Hobby Lobby, I went to Michael's, and they didn't have it. But anyway, I said, okay. So, any other questions? Okay, so don't boil your linseed oil. But, all right, thanks for coming out. Enjoy the rest of your week.